Before watching the video, don't forget to subscribe the channel and enable bell notification to never miss an update from us.
Hello everyone and welcome. This is Ashima Shukla, your current affairs and banking awareness faculty on Entry Platform. And in this video, we are going to talk about everyday news events that have taken place in the past days. This is going to be a short and crisp video for all of you, where you'll be getting all the major information, all the major news events in a very short span of period. And for those who want to practice questions as well, for them we have everyday free live quiz, which is available on Entry app. You can download app from the Google Play Store, for which the link is provided in the description section below. And you can take free of cost live quiz and a lot of mock tests and test series for your practice as well. Now, starting on the discussion with the first news event, Geospatial Energy Map of India. Niti Aayog has launched this Geospatial Energy Map of India to provide a holistic picture of all the energy resources which are present in the country. And for this, they have partnered with ISRO. So, the Comprehensive Geographic Information System Energy Map of India, or GIS map, was launched by Dr. Rajiv Kumarji, who is Vice Chairman of Niti Aayog, V.K. Saraswatji, a member of Niti Aayog, and Sri Amitabh Kantji. And it has been developed by Niti Aayog in partnership with ISRO, or Indian Space Research Organization, as well as energy ministries of the Government of India. So it's going to have all the images of all the conventional power plants, oil gas wells, petroleum refineries, coal fields, coal blocks, and all the 27 thematic layers which are there of resources. So, primary and secondary sources of energy with their transmission network is going to be available. Current chairperson of ISRO is Dr. K. Sivanji, and it is headquartered in Bengaluru. Then we have Mercer Global Pension Index 2021, released by Mercer Consulting, which is a leading global management consulting firm, and it was launched in partnership with CFA Institute and Monash Center of Financial Studies. India is ranked at 40th position in this ranking with a value of 43.3 or a score of 43.3. This is the 13th edition and has been topped by Iceland, which had an index value of 84.2. The second and third positions being Netherlands at second and Norway at third position. Now, then we have the lowest index value at 40, which was of Thailand, which makes us not very high positioned in terms of score. Then we have a few one-liners. Government of India has constituted a working group of suggesting alternate sustainable financial and operational models for Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana so that they can roll out an overhauled Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana scheme for the Kharif 2022 season. The panel head is going to be Ritesh Chauhanji, who is also recently been appointed as the CEO of Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana. So they are going to provide an alternative model and in various states, and they are going to conduct all the detailed study which is required for early settlement alongside. Then we have International Cricket Council and UNICEF, who are about to announce their partnership to raise awareness about mental health issues and well-being among the children and adolescents. So this under this partnership, ICC is going to promote a hashtag On Your Mind campaign of UNICEF at the ICC Men's T20 World Cup 2021, which is soon coming up. ICC will be using its platform to give a boost to this UNICEF's work for getting a greater commitment and a connection and starting the conversation on mental health, as we say. Comrade Amit Rastogiji has been appointed as Chairman and Managing Director of National Research Development Corporation. NRDC is an enterprise of DSIR, Ministry of Science and Technology in the Government of India. Indian Army has been awarded as the gold medal for 2021 Cambrian Patrol Exercise, which was held in Brecon, Wales in United Kingdom recently. And Indian Army was represented by 4 and 5 Gorkha Rifles in the Frontier Force. This drill is sometimes known as Olympics of military patrolling among the militaries of the world, and it is considered as the ultimate test of human endurance and team spirit. Fourth General Assembly of International Solar Alliance has been organized virtually, which was presided by the President of ISA Assembly, that is R.K. Singh ji, as the presidency of ISA lies with India. Therefore, the president has been appointed by India, that is R.K. Singh ji, who is also the Union Minister for New and Renewable Energy. So, there were certain key initiatives which are supposed to be deliberated at this 4th ISA meeting, which includes the OSOWOG, O-S-O-W-O-G, O-S-O-W-O-G, that stands for One Sun, One World, One Grid Initiative, and it's a $1 trillion investment roadmap for 2030, along with other initiatives that might be started. Jammu and Kashmir administration has signed a memorandum of understanding with government of Dubai for a rapid up development and growth in the union territory of Jammu and Kashmir. So Dubai government is going to help in development of real estate sector, industrial parks, IT towers, logistics, medical centers, super specialty halls, hospitals and various other such things. Union Home Minister Amit Shah ji flagged off 5 mobile medical vans, which is dubbed as Modi van, in Kaushambi district of Uttar Pradesh. 5 mobile medical vans are going to operate in the 5 assembly constituencies of Kaushambi, and these vans have been launched under the Seva Hi Sangathan program of BJP to commemorate the Prime Minister Narendra Modi completing 20 years as the head of the government. These vans are going to be under the aegis of Kaushambi Vikas Parishad and is going to be run by the BJP National Secretary Vinod Sonkarji. China has launched their first social exploration satellite into space to study the violent and sudden physical processes behind the solar flares. With a 550 kg or 121 pound satellite called Zihi, which is the name of sun god in Chinese mythology, was launched from Taoyuan Satellite Launch Center in North Shaanxi Province aboard a Long March 2D rocket recently. And then we have India, which has been ranked at 40th position out of 43 in Mercer CFS Global Pension Survey. We have studied detail of it. RBL Bank is working on a new digital platform which is known as Abacus 2.0 to help banks scale up customer acquisition for the next few years. Indian fencer Bhavani Devi ji has won a Charleville national competition in France in an individual women's sabre event. Legendary Indian poet, lyricist, director Gulzar Saab has come out with a new book with the title Actually I Met Him, a Memoir. Union Home and Corporation Minister Amit Shah ji inaugurated various development projects and laid foundation stone for various projects on Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose Island in Andaman and Nicobar Islands. They were worth approximately 1,000 crore rupees, which were initiated on Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Some were inaugurated worth 299 crore, and there were certain for which foundation stone was laid, which was approximately 643 crore rupees. National Stock Exchange has partnered with Chainflux to launch NSE Shine. NSE Shine is a blockchain platform for gold bullion. So it was launched, inaugurated by the executive director of SEBI, that is V.S. Sundareshan ji. And it's going to offer a data framework for the bullion bar integrity for the purpose of settlement of gold derivative contracts. Current MD and CEO of NSE is Vikram Limayaji. Ministerial Roundtable Session of International Telecommunication Union ITU Digital World 2021 was hosted by Vietnam, in which India was represented by Devusin Chonji, who is the Minister of State for Communications as of now. The dignitaries had various discussions on cutting the cost, affordable accesses can accelerate digital transformation. RBI has given approval to Karur Vyas Bank to collect direct taxes on behalf of Central Board of Direct Taxes recently. And with this, we wind up the session. I hope this session has been helpful. We'll see you in the next video with more news events. Till then, have a great day ahead. Take care and see you soon.